Howdy, so that's Flippin Science, we're looking at the physical barriers to infection. The understanding we're looking at is describe the function of the various physical barriers that exist to prevent the entry of pathogens. So one way of stopping pathogens getting in is from physically stopping them from entering the bloodstream. And this is the job of the physical barriers. So skin, eyes, blood, respiratory and digestive system. So we've already mentioned this, we're just going to go into a bit more detail for each of them. So the skin is a dense layer of cells and that physically stops pathogens, things like bacteria and viruses, from getting in. Here's a picture of the skin, you can see the many, many layers. Here's another picture of the skin. So again, we've got many, many layers of cells that prevents the pathogens from getting in. The skin itself is slightly acidic. Its pH is about 5.6, and being slightly acidic allows it to kill some pathogens. When you sweat, you also release lysozyme, which is an enzyme that eats bacterial cell walls. Here's a picture showing a test tube with lysozyme and bacteria in it, and a control test tube with bacteria in it. Without the lysozyme. And we can see with the lysozyme there's no bacteria, but with the control there is. Sweat is also salty, and that can kill bacteria by osmosis. Your eyes are vulnerable to infection, and so your eyes produce tears, and by blinking you spread those tears all over the eyeball. The tears contain lysozyme as well, and they, like I said, they eat the cell walls of bacteria, and that kills the bacteria. Here's a picture down here showing how lysozyme works. So it's the enzyme, it eats into the cell wall, it exposes the cell membrane of the bacteria, and then they can kill it. The tears are also salty and much like sweat, so they can kill bacteria through osmosis. When you wake up in the morning, you'll often notice that you might have this discharge called sleep. And that sleep is a combination of dead bacteria, dead skin cells, oil and mucus, and all that accumulates on the ear, and then as you blink during your sleep, it collects in the corner. Pathogens can enter the body through cuts, burns, and abrasions, so you need to have a system that prevents that from happening. And one thing that happens is in your blood, you have platelets, which are these little bits here, little packets of protein, and what they do is when they detect that you have an open wound, they stick together and they produce proteins that kind of stick together red blood cells and plug up the wound so that the infection can't get in. So we can see it a bit on the knee here, we can see where there's some scabbing happening. That's the clotting that's occurring because of the platelets. In your respiratory system, you have all these membranes that are lined with cells that produce mucus, and we call those mucus membranes. The mucus is sticky, and pathogens and dirt get stuck in the mucus, and they can get digested by enzymes and acids present in the mucus. The cells that line the respiratory system also have cilia, and we can see the cilia down here. So they have these microscopic cilia, and they beat and they push mucus up out of the respiratory system. And out of the lungs. And when that happens, you can cough up that mucus or you can swallow that mucus. So that's a way of getting rid of those pathogens that are deep inside your lungs. In your digestive system, your saliva also contains lysozyme. So that's the enzyme that kills bacteria. Bacteria in your mouth can start to be eaten up by that lysozyme. Bacteria that make it through your mouth and down into your deeper digestive system, if they make it into your stomach has a lot of acid in it. The pH of the stomach is around about the same as the pH of battery acid. So that really low pH kills a lot of bacteria. Inside your intestines, you have a lot of bacteria, your natural flora. Here's a picture showing some of that natural flora, and you can see all these different colors, they're different types of bacteria. Now, if they're present there and they're growing quite happily in the intestines, then that means there's no room, which is one thing that bacteria need, but there's also no food for invasive bacteria. So, there's no space or food or resources for the bacteria, so they just can't get a grip in your intestines. So today on Flipping Science, we looked at physical barriers to infection. That's it for Flipping Science today. See ya.